Oh, so this today topic is the beneficial effect of consuming fish and omega-3 fatty acid on human health. If we are consuming a fish, if we are consuming omega-3 fatty acids, so that is having some beneficial effect in our health. So we will study in detail. So what are the things that we are going to cover today is, so that lipid, what are the lipids and how these lipids are different from other lipids? Then what are the omega-3 and omega-6 and what is their significance? That means omega-3 and omega-6 fatty acid classification is there. And what is the significance of that omega-3 and omega-6 in our health or human health? Can we synthesize EPA and DHA? So that we are also going to study. And whether all the fishes synthesize EPA and DHA. Okay, so this is the content about today's topic. Then classification of lipid is that lipid, as we know, that is which is insoluble in water. Okay, but it is soluble in the organic solvent. Classification of this lipid is the means we are having a three classification: simple, compound, and derived. Simple lipid, that means mostly that triglycerides. Triglyceride, that means glycerol and three molecules of the fatty acid will be esterified. So that is the simple lipid or waxes. And then compound lipid is that the compound, that means there will be glycerol molecules and fatty acid will be also there. And beside this fatty acids, that phosphate group will be there. Or single group will be there, so that's why it is called as a compound lipid. It is not a simple one. Derived lipids are the those lipids which is derived from simple lipid as well as the compound lipid. So example is the steroids and terpenoids. These are the example of this derived lipid. Then coming to the fatty acid, basically in the fat or lipid, we are having the glycerol and fatty acids. This fatty acid, when it will be esterified, then it is going to form the fat or triglycerides, we can say. So this fatty acids, we are having a means classification. We are having the delta series classification. We are having that N3 series classification. We are having the saturated and unsaturated fatty acid classification. We are having that omega-6 or omega-3 series of fatty acid classification. So fatty acid, basically what is this? So basically the fatty acid is the long chain carboxylic acid, okay, which is soluble in what insoluble in water. And basically the fish lipid or fish fatty acids, say having a 12 to 18 carbon atom. Fish lipid, it contains the fatty acids which is having an even number of carbon atoms, not uneven, or we can say the odd number of the carbon atom. So basically 12 to 18. It may also contains 20, 22. Fish contains up to 22 carbon atom, up to 22 carbons or carbon atom. Some contains double bond, which are usually in cis configuration. So in this configuration, we are having a classification. One is the cis, another one is the trans. Cis configuration, that means the hydrogen group will be on the same sides. In case of trans, this hydrogen will be in opposite end or opposite direction, not in opposite direction. So that is the trans configuration. So our this fatty acid, it contains usually in the cis configuration. That is the advantage of that fatty acid which present in our fish. So saturated and unsaturated fatty acid, saturated, we are classifying saturated fatty acids because of the presence of no double bond or presence of the single bond, we can see. That is the absence of double bond in case of saturated fatty acid. Unsaturated fatty acid, there must be one or more than one number of double bonds will be there in the carbon hydrogen. So example, it is the palmitic acid. Palmitic acid is the saturated fatty acid. And another one is the palmitoic acid. That is the unsaturated fatty acid. How we can differentiate here, saturated or unsaturated?
By the multiple bonds.
Saturated में single bond होता और unsaturated में double or more than double bond हो सकता है.
But here example is the palmitic acid and palmitoic acid. Palmitic acid is the saturated. That means there is no presence of any double bond. That is the absence of double bond. Palmitoic acids, we are having a one double bond. So based on the presence of the double bonds, we are classifying the fatty acid, whether it is saturated or unsaturated. Okay. Then structure of this fatty acid, the saturated fatty acid, it fits closely in a regular pattern. Because of that, means this will be in the that in a, because of this fit closely in regular pattern or regular fashion, because of that we can say that inelastic in nature, we can say inelastic, and they're having a high melting point. Whereas the unsaturated fatty acids, they are not fit closely. Why? Because there is the presence of the double bond, and that double bond is having the cis configuration. You can see here, we are having this structure. This structure, you can see this is the cis. That means these two hydrogen atoms are on the same side. अगर ऊपर में है तो ऊपर में ही ट्रांस कॉन्फ़िगरेशन होगा. तो ट्रांस कॉन्फ़िगरेशन के केस में वन विल बी हियर एंड अनदर विल बी डाउन. दैट मींस यहां से ऊपर की ये. हेलो
सर, स्लाइड नहीं दिखेगी
क्या?
सर स्लाइड नहीं शो रहा है.
स्लाइड तो
शो कर रहा है जी. शो कर रहा है
सर.
सबको दिख रहा है? तुम्हारा नेटवर्क का इश्यू हो रहा है, नेटवर्क चेक कर लो.
नेटवर्क प्रॉब्लम होगा.
सो दिस इज द मिस एडवांटेज एंड स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ दिस फैटी एसिड, सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड एंड अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड्स. सैचुरेटेड दे आर हैविंग मींस एब्सेंस ऑफ double bond. They are having a single bond, covalent bond. Unsaturated, definitely there will be a presence of double bond, either a one or more than one. But that double bond basically it will be in the cis configuration. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
Then property of saturated fatty acid, it contains only single bond, that means carbon-carbon bond, closely packed. Because of that single bond, closely packed, and a strong attraction between the chain, there will be a strong attraction or interaction between the chain. That means two fatty acid is there, there will be strong attraction. They are having a high melting point. High melting point, because of this high melting point, they are solid at room temperature. हमारे daily life में हम लोग देखते होंगे example में जो हमारा घी है, घी को देखते हैं ना, वनस्पति oil है, especially dalda. They are having
dalda.
Yeah, they are having मतलब basically they are having the saturated fatty acid. Because of that high melting point, they are in the form of solid.
Coconut oil
जाड़े के दिन में जम जाता है. Why? Because of these properties. Okay. Then property of unsaturated fatty acid is that contain one or more double bond. Non-linear chains do not allow molecules to pack closely because there is a non-linear, there is a presence of the double bond. Because of that, they are not fitting closely and there will be a few interaction between the chain, and they are having a low melting point compared to saturated fatty acid. Basically, it will be in the form of liquid at room temperature. This is our example, mustard oil. Mustard oils, basically it is in the form of liquid. Chahe humara jare ke din ho ya garmi ke din ho. So that is the properties of unsaturated fatty acid, presence of the unsaturated fatty acid. Now, how this triglyceride is formed? Basically, this triglycerides is also called an ester of glycerol and fatty acid. So there is the esterification process. What is happening in the esterification process? There will be one molecule of glycerol and three molecules of the fatty acid.
Fatty acid.
Whether it is a saturated or unsaturated. So here we are having the example. We can see here, this is the glycerol molecules, and we are having a three molecules of the fatty acid. Which fatty acid this is?
Esteric acid, sir.
Palmitic, sir. Palmitic.
Palmitic, sir. Palmitic.
18 carbon. 18 carbon.
नहीं नहीं 18 नहीं वो तो ग्लिसरॉल का है ना मतलब
नहीं 18 कार्बन ना इसमें फैटी एसिड
उधर इधर ग्लिसरॉल का
16 होगा ना वो तो ग्लिसरॉल का है
ना नहीं इसमें तो रखा 18 है ना
ग्लिसरॉल का सीएस को छोड़ करके हमें आंसर चाहिए व्हेदर इट इज ए व्हाट
16
पालमिटिक में 16 कार्बन होते
हैं नहीं 15 हां 16 होता है पालमिटिक ही है सर 16
पालमिटिक ही है सर 16 कार्बन
पहले तो हमें ये पता होना चाहिए जो सैचुरेटेड है या अनसैचुरेटेड है
सर ये सैचुरेटेड है
इसके बाद सैचुरेटेड होना चाहिए सैचुरेटेड में कौन सा है
पालमिटिक सर
पालमिटिक
पालमिटिक एसिड Why? Because you can see we are counting the number of carbon atoms. So we are having a two end, methyl end and carboxylic end. So this is the methyl end and this is the carboxylic end. So one and this is two. Methyl end contains one number, carboxylic acid contains one number. That is the two number. And total we are having a 14 number. So 14 plus 2 is total 16. So 16 is to 0, it means it is a palmitic acid. It is a saturated fatty acid because there is a there is the absence of double bond. So when this three palmitic acid is going to esterified with the one molecules or single molecules of this glycerol, there will be a release of the water. Three molecules of water will release. And there will be formation of the ester bond. And when the ester bond is formed, that means it is a triglycerides. Or we can also say triacylglycerol. When there will be two molecules of this palmitic acid, it is going to esterify with a single molecule of this glycerol. Then we can say it is the diacylglycerol. Because there is a two fatty acid is going to esterify. So like that, it depends upon the how many numbers of fatty acids is going to esterify. If it is one, then what is monoacylglycerol? Okay. So that is this one, this triacylglycerol. Then fat and oils form from glycerol and fatty acid. So this is the glycerol molecule. You can see CH2 OH, CHOH, then CH2OH. This is glycerol, and this is the palmitic acid. Three molecules of palmitic acid. It is going to esterify. Then what it is going to produce? It will produce the triacyl glycerol.
Triacyl glycerol.
Good. Now coming to the PUFA. PUFA is the polyunsaturated fatty acid. We are talking about the PUFA. So fish also contains lots of PUFA in their body, in their liver. Okay, so overall we will discuss here this polyunsaturated fatty acids that cannot be made in the body. That means our human system we are talking are linoleic acid and alpha linolenic acid. And because we are not able to form in our body, that's why these two polyunsaturated fatty acids is called as essential fatty acids. So from where we will get from the food. We are depending on the food. So what type of food we are eating, whether some people are vegetarian, some people are non-vegetarian. So whether that vegetarian people are getting a sufficient amount of this PUFA or essential fatty acid or not, and non-vegetarian, whether they are getting sufficient amount of essential fatty acid. So answer will come now. So within the body, both can be converted to other PUFA. Hamari body ke andar mein dono PUFA jo hai, this within the body, both can be converted to other PUFA. That is the arachidonic acid, icosha pentanoic acid, and docosha hexanoic acid. That means linolenic acid or linolenic acid, if we are consuming, our body is going to synthesize and convert into arachidonic acid, icosa pentanoic acid, and docosa hexanoic acid. So it is a long process for the conversion of linoleic or linolenic acid to DHA. Then PUFA in the body, PUFA are important for what purpose? Maintaining the membranes of all cells. The cells ka jo hamara membrane hai, that cell membrane, it is a bilayer, na? Lipid bilayer membrane is there.
Yes, sir.
So in the lipid bilayer, there will be a lipid. And that lipid is what? Glycerol and fatty acid. So what fatty acid will be there? PUFA. So it also depends upon the lifestyle, food and eating habit of the humans. Whether it is the people's kisi ko acha hota hai hum daily snacks mein jaye, fried item khaye, aram se ke pakoda khaye aaj samosa kha ke hai, kachori kha ke hai, pizza kha ke hai, burger kha ke hai. But ultimately, what you are eating, you must know whether you are eating a PUFA or you are eating that saturated fatty acid. So you must know what kind of food you are going to eat, because it is having some role, physiological role in our body. Then for making a prostaglandin is very important, which regulate many body process, particularly inflammation and blood clotting. Prostaglandin, they are able and they are playing a role in the inflammation. Kisi ko bahut body mein jalan hota hai, dard hota hai. Why? Because of this prostaglandin. It also depends upon which kinds of prostaglandin is forming. वी आर कंज्यूमिंग ओमेगा 3 फैटी एसिड और ओमेगा 6. ओमेगा 3 से अगर जो प्रोस्टाग्लैंडिन बनेगा दैट विल बी ए लेस इंफ्लेमेटरी इन नेचर एंड मींस वी कैन से दिस थ्रोम्बोटिक होता है ना, तो दैट विल बी ए लेस थ्रोम्बोटिक इन नेचर. ओमेगा 6 से अगर होगा तो डेफिनेटली इट विल बी ए हाईली इंफ्लेमेटरी इन नेचर एंड इट मे बी प्रोथ्रोम्बोटिक इन नेचर. So it depends upon the which kinds of prostaglandin is there. Then PUFA, to enable the fat soluble vitamins, especially that vitamins A, D, E and K, that has to be absorbed from the fruit. So this PUFA is playing a role. Agar hum vitamins le rahe hain, especially that fat soluble vitamins, it must be absorbed. So who is going to play a role? So PUFA will help in the absorption of these fat soluble vitamins. Then for regulating body cholesterol mechanism. So we are having this another cholesterol, that's VLDL is there, LDL is there, HDL is there. That means high density lipoprotein, low density lipoprotein, good cholesterol, bad cholesterol. So we will study that in different lecture. So all PUFA fat, including the omega-3s, are increasingly recognized as important to human health. So this PUFA, especially that omega-3, means including this omega-3, are important to human health. Omega-3 falls into this category. Along with the omega-6, another type of PUFA found in grains, most plant-based oils, poultry and eggs. Then researchers have found that without a sufficient supply of PUFA, this polyunsaturated omega-3, the body will use saturated fat to construct the cell membrane. Agar we are not taking a sufficient amount of this PUFA, especially that omega-3, then in the absence of the PUFA, our body is going to saturate the fat to construct the cell membrane. And if that cell membrane, especially the heart cell, if it is made by the saturated fat, then what will happen? Because the heart is continuously pumping. So there must be that elasticity of the heart muscles. But we are consuming this because we are not consuming this PUFA. So heart cell, if it is made from the saturated fat, there will be inelastic in nature. So if it is going to relax and it is not coming back to the in the contraction stage, so what will happen? Our heart will failure. Heart kisi ka fail ho jayega aur wo mar jayega. So that is the advantage and disadvantage of this. Nutritionists have come to recognize the importance of balancing omega-3 fatty acid with omega-6 fatty acid in the diet. See, agar hum continuously omega-3 hi kha rahe hain, omega-6 nahi kha rahe hain, theek hai? So that is also having some importance. That also come in the next lecture, that the importance of this omega-3 and omega-6. So there must be some balance between the omega-3 and omega-6. ऐसा नहीं हम केवल ओमेगा 6 ही ले रहे हैं. दिस सनफ्लावर ऑयल है. इफ यू आर गोइंग टू बाय ए सनफ्लावर ऑयल और राइस ब्रान ऑयल और सोयाबीन ऑयल, रिफाइंड ऑयल जितने भी हैं, यू विल गेट इट्स हाईली मींस दिस मींस अमाउंट ऑफ द PUFA विल बी रिच. व्हाई दे आर राइटिंग हाई इन PUFA? बिकॉज ओमेगा 6 फैटी एसिड इज मोर but not omega-3. So there must be some balance. So hum apne daily life mein kaun sa oil kha rahe hain aur uska kya effect hamare health pe ho raha hai. So agar humko pata hoga to wo hum usko apne ghar mein khareed ke la sakte hain aur usko apne family ko bhi khila sakte hain. So there must be some balance. Omega-3 koi bhi oil hai, there should be some balance. ओमेगा 3 और ओमेगा 6 दोनों का. बिकॉज मोस्ट पीपल्स ऑन टिपिकल वेस्टर्न डाइट कंज्यूम फार मोर ओमेगा 6 रिच फूड, इंक्लूडिंग क्या कौन सा फूड जिसको हैबिट है खाने का, सीरियल्स, होल ग्रेन ब्रेड, बैक्ड फूड्स सॉरी गुड्स, फ्राइड फूड्स, मार्गरिन एंड अदर्स, एंड द रेशियो इज आउट ऑफ बैलेंस फॉर ऑलमोस्ट एवरी वन. दिस मीन्स फॉर मोस्ट ऑफ अस द एम्फेसिस नाउ नीड टू बी इंक्रीजिंग ओमेगा 3s to make the ratio more even. So we must have to balance. ऐसा नहीं है केवल ओमेगा 3 खाएं ओमेगा 6 ना खाएं. There must be some balance. Not only fish has been found to be good for the heart, but also it is good for the brain. अगर हम fish consume करते हैं तो हमारे केवल heart को ही मदद नहीं कर रहा है. It is also a good for the brain. Brain development. So example will come how this brain development is coming. Fish oils are healthy because they contains two essential omega 3 fatty acids, especially the EPA and DHA. EPA is the eicosapentaenoic acid. That means this omega 3 series is this fatty is omega 3 series. Eicosaenoic that means 20. Pentaenoic that means 5. Fatty acid. That means 20:5. Docosa hexanoic. Docosa that is 22. Hexanoic. That means number of double bond will be 6. Then fatty acid. So these are particularly valuable as nutrient for the cell of the brain and nervous system, the eyes, and the adrenal and sex gland. इस सब के डेवलपमेंट में EPA एंड DHA का बहुत बड़ा रोल है. किस किस का? ब्रेन डेवलपमेंट में, नर्वस सिस्टम को डेवलपमेंट में, आईज में, स्पेशली दिस रेटिना पार्ट जो है हमारा, रेटिना में बहुत सारा DHA होता है जो हमारा विजुअल पावर को वो पावर देता है. देन दिस ग्लैंड एड्रेनल ग्लैंड एंड सेक्स ग्लैंड. So DHA and EPA is playing a role. So that's why we must have to have some EPA and DHA in our diet. So this is the omega 3 and omega 6 polyunsaturated fatty acid. How we are talking about this omega 3 and omega 6. How we can differentiate omega 3 and omega 6?
Position of double bond decides if it is omega 3 or omega 6. From methyl side.
Anyone?
Sorry.
Anyone?
So methyl side pe numbing karenge aur double bond position agar 3 pe aata hai to omega 3 aur 6 double bond ka position. Sir functional group ko chhod sakte hai.
Anyone?
So number of double bond
भी depend करता है.
Anyone? Okay. Now I will tell the answer. If I ask. If I ask how we are going to classify the omega 3 or omega 6, so you have to answer that the first number of double bond present in the fatty acid from methylene. You must have to tell the first number of double bond. Rest ko count karne ki zarurat hi nahi hai. जो पहला डबल बॉन्ड जहां पे अकर हो रहा है, जहां पे वो है, उसको हम मिथाइलिन से काउंट करेंगे. यहां पे वी कैन काउंट हियर, से फॉर एग्जांपल दिस मिथाइलिन इज दिस वन एंड कार्बोक्सिलिक एंड इज दिस वन. सो वी हैव टू काउंट फ्रॉम दिस एंड मिथाइलिन. हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू काउंट? वन कार्बन एटम, सेकेंड कार्बन एटम सॉरी, एंड दिस इज द थर्ड कार्बन एटम. It means The first double bond is occurring at the third number of the carbon atom from methylene. That's why we are calling, or we can tell that this is the omega-3 unsaturated fatty acid. Then, how much number of carbon atom is there? So we can identify. Yeah, ho gaya. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. 18 number of carbon atom. Then how many number of carbon atom? How many number of double bonds? 1, 2, 3. So 18 is to 3. And this is the N3, because the first double bond is present at third number of carbon atom from methylene. So this 18 is to 3 is the alpha linolenic acid. So like that, we must have to count all these fatty acids, 1, 2, 3, these are the omega-3, because the first double bond present on the third number of carbon atom. Okay? So this is the EPA, this is DHA. 20 is to 5, 22 is to 6. Then omega-6 classification, same process we have to do. Here also we have to check the first double bond is occurring on what carbon atom? On which carbon atom? So from methylene, we have to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the omega 6. Then how many number of carbon atom? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18. And then how many numbers of double bond? 1 and 2. So 18 is to 2 and 6. That is the linoleic acid. So these are the omega 6. Okay, don't forget this. This is very important and most commonly come in the competitive exam. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is same omega 3. Kaise hum usko karenge? Okay. Then omega 3, we are having this alpha linolenic acid. Then eicosapentaenoic acid, docosahexaenoic acid. These are the omega 3. Alpha linolenic acid, scientific abbreviation hai 18 is to 3 and 3. That means 18 number of carbon atom will be there, 3 number of double bonds will be there. And these are the N3 series or omega 3. N3 or omega 3, both are same. Don't confuse. So it is required for health, but cannot be synthesized in human. So this you must have to remember which fatty acid our body is going to synthesize. So this is the base. That means this is the base. From them, we are going to synthesize EPA, DHA, and arachidonic acid. But our body is not going to synthesize this ALA, alpha linolenic acid. So this fatty acid is present where? So answer will come, don't worry. Human can synthesize other omega-3. Omega-3, alpha-linolenic acid to synthesize nahi kar pa raha hai humara body. That's why it is a very essential. We must have to get from the diet. But our body is going to synthesize EPA and DHA. Lekin for that, we need base material. That is the omega-3 fatty acid, unsaturated fatty acid, which is अल्फा लिनोलेनिक एसिड और लिनोलिक एसिड. So this EP and DHA are usually referred as a marine derived omega-3 fatty acid because they are abundant in certain species of the fishes. See, our body is going to synthesize this EP and DHA, but we need the base material. Base material is the alpha-linolenic acid. Then only our body is going to synthesize. But if we are not consuming such type of food, such type of plant-based food, that means we are not getting a sufficient amount of ALA. So our body will not synthesize. But we are having a ready-made use. From them, directly we can get the EP and DHA. So for that purpose, we must have to eat and consume fish. Because the fish is having a rich source of omega-3, especially the EPA and DHA. And marine environment fishes, they're having an abundant source of EPA and DHA. That's why you must have to eat marine fish. They must have to include in our diet marine fish. Why? Because the quantity of omega-3, especially EPA and DHA, will be more in case of marine fish. Okay? ALA, basically, we are getting from the plant-derived, that means plant-based food. Plant-based, especially that oil, we are talking about the oils or fat. We are taking this all, sunflower oil, soybean oil, then mustard oil, then Siamese oil, then olive oil, then other means plant-based derived or plant extracted oils, we can see. So from them, we will get the omega-3 fatty acid. So example, you can see here. Time is going to end. If it is going to end, then again you have to rejoin by using the same link and same password, user ID and password. So example is alpha-linolenic acid, which we are getting from the plant. The flaxseed oil is there. If we are serving 1 tablespoon of flaxseed oil, we are going to get 8.5 gram of this ALA, alpha-linolenic acid. Then walnut, 2.6, flaxseed, 2.2, walnut oil, 1.4, canola oil, 1.2, mustard. Generally, हमारे घर में mustard ही use करते हैं. तो कितना हमको linolenic acid मिल रहा है? 0.8 gram. अगर एक चम्मच हम डालते हैं अपने खाने में तो सोयाबीन ऑयल रिफाइन ऑयल जो है 0.9, वॉलनट ओलिव ऑयल्स सॉरी वॉलनट 0.6 ब्लैक कलर का है तो ओलिव ऑयल 0.1, ब्रोकोली अगर रॉ है सो फ्रॉम देम वी कैन गेट 0.1. सो दिस इज द टेबल फ्रॉम that means which is means showing the sources from them.